We're going to get to studio.co.org. We're going to start with course two today, you guys.
One of the great things about code.org is that it's a way where you can actually do some coding. It has a lot of math into it as well.
But you have to do it at 120 degrees, so if you actually show it now.
Degree angles that they're changing, there's a pixel length that they're doing, they have to add and subtract some things here and there. What I like about it is that it actually gets a little more involved into coding itself. I've read a lot of articles about coding in schools nowadays, and I think it was around 90% of schools in the United States don't even teach coding. My undergrad degree is in computer science, so it's one thing I really want to press towards the kids to do.
And you turn left 90 degrees and move forward 100 pixels.
One thing I like for them to do is to go in front of the class. We utilize the smart board that we have here. It's a pretty neat tool because not only do the kids get to show off what they're learning in the code, but it makes them feel pretty good when they come up and actually can accomplish something in front of all their classmates. Code.org is actually a really great website. One of the greatest things I like is that for each of my classrooms, I've actually went in there as a teacher and had each student with their own accounts. I can sit back with my tablet and I can look at how Johnny's doing or how Jane's doing in the class. I can see them progress as they go. I can see if they skipped around. I can see everything to make sure they're on task and continuing on. One thing I'm finding out is that if you're really good at math, you're actually really good at coding. And some that aren't, what they're learning in code.org actually is going to benefit them in their math class as well.